about it when the guys came back.
Is that drinking shop?
Yes. Quite like it. I really like this strange configuration. It's good.
Come in closer. Mm. So, what's the most awkward silence?
Can't really think of one.
Yeah, for me, an awkward silence is watching a film with your parents when a very explicit sex scene comes on.
Recent awkward silence was walking out of the toilet at the Tim Burgess book launch while I was recovering from gastroenteritis. Done.
The music's always been about a mishmash of different genres. Everyone brings something different to the sound. Yeah, I just think it's really unique. And also the way the band operates. Paul gives everyone a lot of free rein in what they do, and he listens to everyone, and it just makes it a really nice experience.
First time I saw Paul Hawkins, it was downstairs in the Barfly, and he did like a 15-minute set which seemed to be like only two songs, and it was just this torrent of words, and the ones I could catch really made me laugh.
So I think I was doing a gig in a cafe in Brighton, and Paul was on the bill. We all went to the beach beforehand and had sandwiches, and I invited Paul along, and I remember him thanking me actually for inviting him to the beach. And you know, since then we have lived together, been on Pointless together, and One of course, and I think probably basically been in every conceivable human situation there is.
He had this punk rock swagger masking the internal turmoil. but it was, yeah, it really worked. It really clicked that night, and I think he really found the best way to put his music across.
Having seen the Awkward Silences over a number of years, I guess the time I actually fell in love with them and fell in love with the music was at the 12 Bar at a gig that was promoting We Are Not Other People. And the spectacle, I think, you had Niall and Alex were wearing different animal heads, and Lunch was wearing like a mankini years before Borat. And Paul was in, I remember it as a gold or silver Lurex suit, and wandering around the crowd, sort of Nick Cave birthday party-like. And I thought, this is the fucking bollocks.
I mean, I always enjoy listening to Paul doing his acoustic solo stuff, but when the band gets together and they're all revved up, it's dynamite.
Yeah, I've been in his band, he's been in my band, so I know the Awkward Silences very well, and always looking forward to seeing what they come up with next, especially seeing that he stole half my band.
But that was sort of where the band name came from. But I've always had this fascination with people who should be celebrating, but they aren't. I think that's what I love about the idea of Awkward Silences. So, for example, the idea of kind of someone who's kind of sat at a surprise birthday party where the person the party's for never turns up, and I feel that's kind of what my What I feel the songs and band are about are people who are kind of holding surprise birthday parties, people who got distracted on the way. I think that's generally what we are as a band, and I can't really explain it more than that.
You're glad that they've come. Then the moment's gone, though the memory lives on. Everything feels wrong now, there's no organized fun.
to the execution. Admission cost £15. We've a woman who drowned her baby. We've a man who burned Parliament down. There's additional entertainment. We're gonna stage a live debate. Do we have the right to end killers' lives? Is the risk of an error too great? We know they were found guilty. We don't know the reason why, but we speculate at the cause of hate whilst other people die. Greetings to your master general. Let's decide whether to start a war. Perhaps we'll end a million lives. Perhaps we'll save a million more. We could weigh up the arguments. Will we stop what we want to foil? Or you could just scream that I hate the flag. I could scream you want the oil. Stand up in Parliament, talk bravely of sacrifice. I'll still be standing there in Parliament when other people die.
Outsider pup Cat. Mary asked me to let you know that she is very sorry that she couldn't be very involved in the making of this album because she was working on her PhD, which she does not wish to talk about. We're hoping that she'll be back soon, though. In the meantime, please wear a mask without a valve and wear it over your nose and keep a safe distance from other people. Stay safe and we'll see you soon.
We're having fallen in love with the awkward silences at the 12 bar. I thought, we've got, they're the ones that got away. How come they're not on Blang? So when we went out for Joe Buzzfuzz, Joe Murphy's stag night, and I knew Paul was going to come along, I thought, right, okay, I'll pick my moment. Suitably late, suitably inebriated, suitably confused by alcohol, I said to Paul, I'd really love to put something out on Blang. Here's a budget of, which was a chunk of dough. And we went on to make fabulous videos with a BAFTA award-winning animator that no one's ever seen. But now there's a new album, and this one is even better than the last one, and I'm so fucking excited.
There was so much in the record that I could relate to, particularly Count Each Mistake, a process I go through most mornings. But it's a really beautiful album, and I think it's definitely his best. And it's there's been many formats of the Awkward Silences, Paul Hawkins and the Awkward Silences, but I think they've really cracked it now.
Just testing.
Look at the camera here. So, I catch it.
I think one of the big challenges facing any musician who wants to identify themselves as a disabled artist is that we live in a society where there are still assumptions about how much disabled people can contribute. And I think there's still this sense of, you know, it's nice to let disabled people have a go, but there's no way they're going to create anything that's actually good, and certainly not anything that will appeal to a wider audience. I'm probably not the best person at challenging that second assumption.
I tried hard to be normal. I didn't have much fun. My normal was never normal enough to convince anyone. And what an aspiration, what a silly social lie. The only things the normal share are the things that they try to hide. And the scientists fix my genes to prevent this awful tragedy. Religious men fall to knees and pray. It was his plan, I was born this way. I opened up the paper. The very first thing I see is the early signs they have designed a cure for being me. Of course, nobody asked me. Well, I know what I would say. What you waiting for? Give me the cure so I can finally be okay. So the scientists fix my genes to stop your children being born like me and make them sure. My toast, God bless us, everyone. What a scientist, fix my genes. I ponder the essence of personality. Our experience makes identity. Would a different me even still be me? Scientist, fix my genes. Scientist, fix my genes. Scientist, fix my genes. Scientist, fix my genes.
Spider-Man and his amazing friends, Iceman and Firestar.
Normally we have a group of songs ready when the current songs are being released. We've started working on the next group of songs, but in this case it's not been the case, so it's going to be interesting to see see what direction we go in. But it's always a good direction, so I've got no concerns.
Special offer in the supermarket was the highlight of my weekend. I drank some tea and I ate a crumpet, then another cup of tea again. Then I read a book on modern romance. Both had money but no time to meet. You called to ask if I was keeping busy. To see, I keep on hoping things will soon get better. My only comfort is these things take time. Every night I write in my diary, everything will probably be fine. I'm so glad I've got so media. Watch my friends as they live their lives. Won't be long before I'm able to join them. Not ready for the world outside. I have good days and I have tough moments. I have nights where I dream of you. I have the luxury of imagination. Everyone else has too much to do.
Look serious, look stoic. You know, you're in search of a better life, but you're not entirely sure if it's waiting for you. Grimly believing. Lovely.
When you feel your life sliding out of control,
nothing is wrong, just carry on.
Seeping through holes in your soul.
Just carry on, cause nothing is wrong.
When you feel you are broken, when you feel nothing's okay, when you feel like staying in bed, hoping the world will go away. Here's a simple trick which will fix you every time. Block out all the noise, pretend you're doing fine. When you feel the good times when every start,
nothing is wrong, just carry on.
There's a pain in your chest and you're sure it's your heart,
just carry on.
when they're unhappy. You want to see them smile. You don't want them to worry about you all the while. Here's what you should tell them to give them peace of mind. Look them in the eye. Say, yes, I'm doing fine.
New World or the New World?
Well, with the UI actually for the bit of the film. We don't know if it's A New World, The New World, or New World, but that song.
I think it's A New World.
A New World.
It's not the New World. Peg my bets for that.
I think it's The New World.
It's New World Order, isn't it?
Paul.
The New World or A New
okay,
World.
So, Paul, what is the single called?
We left the city on the first day of spring and we started heading west. Number 120 in total, we were optimistic, determined and naive. We were convinced by the end of the summer we'd have reached our destination and constructed our new homes. But as the autumn turned to winter, our journey still wasn't complete. Amongst the frostbitten mornings and harsh mountain snow, we began to panic. We began to believe we'd never ever arrive. It was at this point that the preacher, Mr. James Jason Oxley, delivered his finest sermon of all. Rather unusually, he spoke not at all of God, but of our responsibilities to protect each other, inspire each other, and make certain that at the end of our journey, every single one of us, we all arrive together. Something in that sermon, perhaps the way he spoke, meant that as we began to walk that day, we felt as fresh, energetic, and hopeful as we had at the very beginning. The worst day so far. The wind bit hard, rain froze as it fell, the floor was an ice trap, and the cold air cut right through our clothing. When I saw you shivering, I felt I should give you my coat. I looked at you, huddled up in it, sleeves so long they covered your hands. I was ice cold, I was soaked to the skin, but a look in your eyes convinced me I was warmer than I had ever, ever been before. We thought of burying him here. digging a deep hole that led his body inside to sleep forevermore. But Len remembered his words, remembered his determination, remembered his conviction that we would all complete our journey together. We lifted his body onto our shoulders and we began to carry him, knowing we could carry him all the way to our destination. We decided when we arrived, when we built our new settlement, we would find a quiet, beautiful spot and lay him to rest. We would name our town square after him, we would tell tales with bravery to our children.